Hello student, welcome you all. Now today we will discuss about spherical lenses image formation, means image formation by convex or concave lenses. When we will put our object at infinite beyond 2f1 at 2f1 between f1 and 2f1 and at f1, then where will image form by convex or concave lenses? First we will find position of the object, where we will put our objects. First we put our object at infinite. First condition is at infinite. In case when object is infinite, then we do not put our object on the principal axis. It means that light rays comes parallel to the principal axis. First condition, when object is infinite, then light rays comes parallel to the principal axis. When light ray, we have discussed in previous video about rules of the convex lenses. When light ray goes parallel to the principal axis, after refraction, it passes through focus. Second, again, parallel to the principal axis, it will go after refraction at the focus. It means that this is the position of the image. When light rays comes parallel to the principal axis or comes from infinite, then image is formed. Nature of images, listen carefully. There are two types of images. First is real image, second is virtual image. Real image is always inverted. Real image means in which light rays after reflection or refraction, real image. In this case, light rays are after refraction meeting at this point, really. So this is real image. First nature is images real and inverted. Real and inverted. And second, size of image is very small. Points anyway. Size of image is small. Size of image is very small. First is image is real inverted. Second, size of image. Third, Image is formed at F2. Dear student, we have already discussed about F1 and center of curvature. Double of F1 is C1. In previous videos, we have discussed about center of curvature. This is C1. And we know that we can write in the place of C1, 2F1. And in the place of C2, 2F2. First condition is that when object is at infinite, then image is real inverted and size of the image is very small. And now in second case, when object is at beyond 2F1, and position of object is this, and to form image of any object, we travel any two light rays. First, now light rays parallel to the principal axis. And by rule, we know that any light rays which goes parallel to the principal axis by convex lens passes through focus of the lens. Second, light rays through optical center, these rays meet at this point. Position of the image is beyond F2 and 2F2. Again, nature of this image is nature light rays after refraction really at meeting at point at this point. So image is real and inverted. Real and inverted. Image position of image is between F2 and 2F2. This is the position. Second is position of image is between F2 and this. Third is size of image. Size of image is smaller than object. Smaller than object. This is second case. When object is beyond 2F1, then image is formed between F2 and 2F2, and light rays after refraction dealing at meeting at a point. So it means that image is real and inverted. Size of image is smaller than the object. Third case is, now third case, when object is at 2F1, थर्ड केस इज फर्स्ट इज एट इनफाइनाइट, सेकंड इज व्हेन ऑब्जेक्ट एट बियॉन्ड 2f1 एंड नाउ व्हेन ऑब्जेक्ट इज एट 2f1. फर्स्ट विल थ्रू लाइट वेल ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस, आफ्टर रिफ्रैक्शन लाइट गोज थ्रू फोकस. सेकंड विल ट्रेवल लाइट थ्रू ऑप्टिकल सेंटर. दिस इज द पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्टिंग ऑफ दीज टू लाइट रेज. सो दिस इज द कंडीशन of light rays. When object is at 2f1, then image, nature of image is again light rays after refraction reeling at a really meeting at a point. It means that image is real and inverted. First condition is real and inverted. Second, real and inverted, and position of image, position is at 2f2. Third, first image is real inverted, and second, what is the position of image? Third, size of image. Size of image is equal to this size of object. When we put our object at 2f1, then height of image and height of object remains always equal. Now, when object is at between f1 and 2f1, this is the position of object. Now, we have to find position of image. So, first we will travel light rays parallel to the principal axis, and we know that after refraction light goes through focus. This is the first condition of light rays. Second, we will travel light rays through optical center. Now, these light rays meeting at this position. This position is beyond 2f1. Again, we have to find nature of this image. In this case of this nature, first we are observing that light rays after refraction really meeting at this point. It means that image is real. Image is real, and real image is always inverted. Image is really inverted. Second, we will find position. Position is beyond 2f2. Position is beyond 2f2. And third is size. Size of image is greater than object. This is certain. When object is between f1 and 2f1, then nature of image is real inverted, position is beyond 2f2, and size of image is greater than the object. Now, next condition is when object is at f1, we will find position of the image. First, we travel light parallel to the principal axis, and we know that light goes parallel to the principal axis after refraction goes through focus of the lens, convex lens. Second case, we will travel light parallel to the principal axis. These light rays meet far away from the lens, and image formed at infinite. In this case, when object is at f1, image formed at infinite. First, light rays going really after refraction. It means that image is real and inverted. Second, position of the image is at infinite. Position is at infinite. And size of image is very large. Size of image is large. Or we can write size of image is larger than the objects. We can add size of image is larger than the object. Last important term is when object is between optical center and focus. In this case, light first conditions, we throw light parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, light goes through focus. And second, we throw light through optical center. In this case, light rays diverges, and diverging light rays never meets each other. And now we draw light backward directions. Light rays backward direction, and this is the position. Image formed at left hand side. In this case, nature of images, light rays after refraction appears to meet, and all the images when light rays appears to meet forms virtual and direct. This is virtual and direct image, and second position is left of lens, and third is size of images. Size of image is greater than the object. Greater than object. Now, in case of concave lens, only two cases are given to find image formation by concave lenses. First, when object is at infinite. In case of infinite, we throw light parallel to the principal axis and light rays diverges and appears coming from focus. And again, second ray parallel to the principal axis, light diverges but appears coming from focus. This is a position of image. Again, to find nature, when light rays appears to meet, in this case, image is virtual and direct. So this image is virtual and direct. Second, left of the lens. Third, very small in size. Now last point is when we put anywhere from the optical center, object anywhere from the optical center. Suppose this is the position of object. Now to find image formation of this, first we will travel light parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, light diverges and appears to come from focus. And second, through optical center. This is the position. In case when we put object anywhere from optical center, in case of concave lens, then image is formed. Light is not really meeting at this point, so image is virtual and direct. Virtual and direct. Position is between F1 and optical center. Size of image is smaller than object. Size of image H is smaller than object. Dear student, these are image formation by convex and concave lenses. These are very important to solve numericals related to concave and concave lenses. To solve numericals related to convex and concave lens, first you have fully knowledge about image formation by these lenses. When object is at infinite and is at F1, at 2F1, between F1 and 2F1, and in case of concave lenses, when object is at infinite and anywhere from the optical center, this is the nature of image.